With CAD Sketcher being so new and so heavily under development, the workflows and how exactly to use its features are still sort of being figured out. So let me share with you what I've figured out so far, hopefully helping you in your CAD Sketcher journey. First things first, remember that CAD Sketcher is not a replacement for CAD programs. It's a project looking to bring CAD-like functionalities and features to the world of mesh. A solid foundation in mesh modeling will really help out. And if you don't know where to get started for that, check down in the description, as I've linked some great resources down there. Lastly, our awesome community needs our support to keep this dream going. Every little bit counts, even just $2 a month goes a very long way. Starting it all off, I want to mention that there's actually two different types of workflows with CAD Sketcher that I've found. The one that you're looking at right this minute, that there is what I like to call the in-place workflow, which is very similar to the actual sort of CAD style modeling, where you very much work trying to referencing off faces or off datum planes and things like that, except it has a couple of extra little quirks, considering that we're having to reference off geometry that isn't actually there in the real space when it comes to modifier bevels and things like that. Now, as you can see, it is a lot of clicking. I have done a whole bunch of clicking to this. This has been sped up by 1000%, and then I times it by 2. So this is a 2000% read time. Now, it is great because it is fully parametric in the sense that it is CAD style parametric precision. And it's got its pros as well as its cons. Remember that we're trying to do something very CAD-like inside of Blender. Here you can see me editing it up. I had to actually go into each plane and change it to get that sort of bevel to carry on. This here is what I like to call the linked duplicate workflow, where you basically just create the basic shapes, and then from there create linked duplicates, referring back to that sketch that created that shape. This is a very powerful way of both utilizing Blender's linked duplicate sort of feature along with CAD Sketcher precision feature. So as you can see here, I've gone and just going to create the little USB hole that I'm going to do here. And then I'm just going to pretty much use CAD transforms to place it and then use just modifiers from Blender. Brilliant part about this is, like very much a CAD model, I can just quickly change and edit the sketch itself to turn this from normal USB to micro USB. So now that you've seen it really quickly in action, let's slow it down and break it down to the features that I used inside of both of those workflows. Most importantly, I would probably say understanding the types of work planes that you're working with. So there's three different types. There's a sketch one, which is a planes work plane. Now this work plane here, you'll see we get in here, we'll create a shape of some sort, and then we can leave it saying with a mesh, and that's it there. Now if I wanted to move this work plane, I can't, because this is a plane work plane. This has been set to the cardinal planes of Blender, so to speak. So that's where you're sort of constrained right there. So with that said, let's get this mesh here. Let's give it a nice little solidify now. We'll give it some nice distance. Let's go in the positive. And let's then give this a bevel, because the whole point of this is to show you how we can then do some other types of work planes. So here we have a bevel. Brilliant. Now I've shown you this before. If you haven't seen it in the first video, we click on this and we have an add mesh, add a work plane to mesh. So this means we literally just click on this mesh, and yes, this is modifier mesh here. So you can't usually interact with this type of mesh, but because it is basically sort of Radial add-on, you could actually just click here and it creates a work plane to that face right there. Just exactly the same here. We can now go add sketch, select this work plane that we have just created, create whatever it is that we're wanting to create here, doing whatever lovely precision stuff. Then we'll go turn this to mesh. We'll leave the sketch. I will then press W to go into my normal selection to then select the mesh. We will solidify it some more as always, and then we'll push that out. Brilliant. So now we have that right there. Okay, now what about this other work plane? Because that's two. Well, there is a third one. If you click and hold here, you have the normal work plane and add work plane. So now that that has been selected here, we can click and drag it out, and here it is. Now, first things first, right here, we have a dialog that lets us control where this is. So I'm just going to click and drag this, set that to zero. And now I know that that is in the zero. And here we have the orientation. I'm going to click and drag, set that to zero. I can then drag this up on the Z sum. I can then say on the X, I want this to be tilted by 45 degrees. Fantastic. And then that is now done. Unfortunately, there is no way of getting back to that dialogue as of right now, but I'm sure something in the future will be sorted out there. Okay, now let's talk about moving these work planes. Well, it's actually pretty simple. Just make sure that you're on the selector, the solve paste selector, and then this origin point right here, you can right click it and there's options here. As you see, there isn't one for rotation right now, but that's due to the maths that's going on. I'm sure something will get developed here soon, but this lets you change the location of where these work planes are. And that is the same for this other one right here. So we can right click it, change the location. If you can't see it, make sure that it is visible right here. And then we can just right click, change it to wherever it is that we're wanting to. Now you're seeing that the mesh has not updated with it. If you want the mesh to update with it, you need to go into that sketch and then leave that sketch, and then that will update everything after that. So that there is work planes. Next, let's talk about arraying. There are two ways of arraying. One of them is quite manual. It is this mess right here. You basically have to manually put in everything. And considering that right this minute, there isn't a copy and paste, this can be quite tedious. So there is another way of doing it through this very much precision CAD style modeling, which would be using this, where you just do one in its place right there, properly referenced everywhere. And then once you've done that, you basically have to make sure you select the right thing, then go over to modifiers, do a lovely array, and then you're going to be able to change this from a relative over to a constant offset here, and then just pull that out. And then once you get that out to a point, you can then just pull this out like that. Something that is very similar to this is also that link duplicate workflow right here. Now, the only thing that's different is right here is the sketch that is then linked and moved into position. And then once it's moved into position, you can change it right here as well. So that is sort of arraying. Now, there is one other type of arraying that you've probably realized that I haven't mentioned yet, which is radial arraying. And that one's a little bit different. When I say different, I do mean ridiculously different. So first we need to create one empty, and then we need to create yet another empty as well. Now we need to get this empty in the center of that face. I'm going to be using CAD transforms for this. I'll press G, press O, I'll snap from here, press Shift F to snap it to the face center. If you do not know CAD transforms, I have an entire video linked down in the description or in the cards. So next up, we need to actually get this pair one to be perfectly in the same place as this mesh here. To do that, it's actually pretty simple. Just click this, shift click here, right click, copy all to selected. And again, for the rotation, right click, copy all to selected. We need to have this empty in the exact same origin point as the sketch itself. Now that that's been done, it's nice and fun. We're just going to shift click, taking this empty to that empty, so the child to the parent. I'm going to press Control P to parent these together. And now that that's been done, it's sort of the same sort of, how I would call the arraying, the radial array workflow of Blender, where we're just going to click array here. We're going to tell it to do an object offset, and this object offset, we're going to click on this empty here. This means we can now grab this empty up here. We can rotate this on the Z some amount that we want, and then we can go back to this one here and just increase the count like that. Yes, it is a little bit more involved. Well, a lot more involved, but that is how you go about doing it. It can be a little bit frustrating, but just be aware that it can be possible. Yes, I completely get it. What you've just saw there was an absolute monstrosity. And for those of you that come from CAD modeling, that must have been utterly hell to look at, because you're used to your lovely, easy radial arrays and arraying of all type. Remember, we are completely first in development here for this. So with your support, we can always improve this. Remember, just $2 a month really means a lot. And you do need a solid understanding of mesh modeling, because we're not looking to replace CAD programs with this. We're just looking to bring CAD functionality and features to Blender. With that said, let's get back into it. Now let's talk about that linked duplicate workflow. So as we know, I've got two sketches here. These are basically fully defined in the way that they are, right there and right here. Brilliant. Okay, so they're just simple planes. So let's do Alt D for a linked duplicate. Now, because this is a linked duplicate, I can go back into here. I can change this by some ridiculous amount, let's say 20. And this is now nice and long. And you'll see that that's changed it there. And it's also changed it over in my sketch over here. This is how all of this has been created. Now, if you ever want to duplicate something and you don't want it to stay linked, all you have to do is normal duplication, which is Shift D. And this is now no longer linked. So if I went back to this sketch here, change this back over to 13, and then I click this sketch, you'll see that that is not linked. But what happens if you do want it to be linked once again? Well, to relink it, just click this, then shift click there, go control L for linked, and then what we're looking for here is to link the object data. That is now relinked into here. So if we were to change this in some manner, shape, or form, so let's change this to 7 now, and we go back over here, that has now been relinked together. One of the key things to keep in mind about these linked duplicates is that the modifiers can be different for each and every single one of them. Even though they're linked duplicates, it doesn't mean that they have to have the same modifier stack to them. Lastly, to finish it all off, let me show you a lovely little modifier stack that I really like. So make sure that this is convert to mesh. I'm going to leave the sketch to right here. We're going to add a modifier, and this is going to be a screw modifier. I'm going to set the angle to 0, and then this screw here, this is the height of the walls. That's right, this is what I'm going to be doing. It's some sort of a room, let's say. And then now that I have this lovely screw upwards, I can then add a solidify. Let's make sure that that is an even thickness. We're going to solidify this way. I want this to be in the positive, but we have a problem. There's no floor. So what should we do here? A linked duplicate. Let's select it here, go Alt D to link duplicate, right click to cancel the movement. All we have to do is actually just delete the solidify and then decide whatever the thickness of the floor is going to be. Of course, if you want, you can go into the minus, but just be aware that you're going to have this little thing going on down there. Right, and there you have it. Of course, this here is lovely and parametric. We can just go back to the sketch and we can change this up. Let's go for something nice and big this way. Let's change the angle of this one as well. Let's go something weird like that. Leave the sketch and there we have it. The entire room is changed to something completely different. And that there is still only just scratching the surface of CAD Sketcher. There is so much more still to come. In fact, go and check out the roadmap that is also linked down in the description so you can see the amazing things that are coming. We aren't even at first release. Thanks to all my patrons you've just seen there, and a big thank you to my VIP makers, Jem Oskanak and David Fernandez. If you think I'm worthy of your support, I would love to see you there too. Remember that there is a Discord that is linked down in the description as well. Thank you for watching. Keep making and let the quest continue.